Welcome to another session of Quant. As normally I recommend, try to solve the questions on your own before you look at the solutions. Also, it is recommended that you identify the question is easy or tough before you start solving it. And if you feel the questions are easy, then try solving in your mind. And these are a few rules which will help you to prepare well for the Quant section. So A and B throw one dice each simultaneously. Find the probability that difference in the digits shown by on the dice is a non-zero number divisible by 3. Non-zero number divisible by 3 can be only 3, because 6 is not possible, because the dice will show 6 and 1 and the difference will be maximum 5, which is not possible. That means the maximum difference can be 3. If the maximum difference is 3, let's look at how 3 can come. You can have 1, 4, 4, 1, 2, 5, 5, 2, 6, 3 and 3, 6. So if you look at that, 6 ways where you can have difference as 3. Total number of ways of throwing 2 dice is 6 into 6, 36 ways. So we can make out the probability is 6 out of 36, or you can say 1 out of 6, D option. Team A and B play football match, score of 3-3. In how many different ways could the goals have been scored given team A never had a lead over team B during the match? So this has to be done very systematically. Now if team A never had a lead over team B, that means the first goal has to be scored by B. Now when you look at the second goal, it can be scored by A or B. There are two cases possible. It can be either scored by A or B. Now let's look at the first case. If a second goal is scored by A, the third has to be scored by B, because B has to be always have a lead over A. And there are three more goals to be scored. In the three more goals, B has to score one more goal, in which case B can either score on the fourth or the fifth, two ways of doing it. Technically, if you look at it, I can have B, A, A, or I can have A, B, A. These are two ways which are possible. So this particular case gives me two ways. Let's look at next way, BB. The moment you have BB, now you have four places to put goals. And you have only one B which can be there. And the B can be either third goal or fourth goal or fifth goal. Three options. If I put it, it will go like this. It can be B, A, A, A. Or it can be A, B, A, A. Or it can be A, A, B, A. So three ways. So totally, if you look at it, it is five ways, and that is the answer. Little tricky, you need to be a little careful while solving it, but if you do it systematically, I believe you should get the answer. So try to be a little bit more systematic when you solve the questions. That helps to figure out the answer in a much better way. A sold a chair for 2000 and incurred a loss. Had A sold an item for 3600, his gain would have been equal to 3 times the amount of loss. So let's say 2000 and 3600. I'm just putting in a diagram format. And let his cost price be here. So this is loss, this is gain. His loss X and profit is 3X, because profit is equal to 3 times the amount of loss. If you look at difference of here is 1600, which means if I divide in the ratio of 1:3, it becomes 400 and 1200. So from that, I can make out the cost price is 2,400. If the cost price is 2,400 and the profit is 20%, you should be good at calculating 10%, 20%. 10% I know is 240. So 20% will be 480. You will get the selling price as 2880 at 20% profit. So if you do it properly and if you know that, okay, 1,600 is the difference, and the ratio of loss to profit is 1:3, you can easily make out 400, 1200. From that, you can make cost price of 2400 and then add 20% profit, you get 2880. You can do this orderly if you want, but requires a little practice. Do that, I'm sure it will help you be fast. Speed of the ship in still water is 36 km per hour and speed of stream is 12. That means I can say downstream speed is 36 plus 12. 48 and upstream speed is 36 minus 12, 24 kilometers per hour. Now they're saying that downstream takes 3.5 hours less than upstream. So time for downstream is time for upstream minus 3.5 hours. Distance of A to B is downstream, is 24 kilometer more. Now let's look at 24 kilometer. How long will it take to travel 24 kilometer? To travel 24 kilometer downstream, he will take 24 upon 48, time is equal to distance upon speed, which will be half an hour. Right? He is already traveling half an hour more from downstream. Now for downstream to be 3.5 hours less, that means his upstream speed for the remaining time should be 4 hours more than the downstream speed. Let's take a number. Let's take distance as 48. If I take distance as 48 kilometers, let's say, then the time taken for downstream will be 1 hour because 48 kilometers per hour. Time taken for upstream will be 2 hours because at 24 kilometers per hour. So at 48 kilometers, the difference is 1 hour. At 48 kilometers, the difference is 1 hour. I want a difference as 4 hours because upstream should take 4 hours more than downstream. It has to cover this 0.5 hours. So 4 hours, the distance taken by upstream will be 48 into 4, 192 kilometers. Right? Distance is 192 kilometers for upstream. Downstream, he takes 24 kilometers more. So 192 plus 24, 216 kilometers. That will be the answer. I repeat again. He actually has to take downstream time 3.5 hours less as compared to upstream. But the 24 kilometer extra takes him half an hour extra. That means in the remaining distance, which is equal distance for both, the downstream time has to be 4 hours less than the upstream time. So in 48 kilometers, the difference is 1 hour. To make the difference as 4 hours, you have to multiply by 4 to get 192 kilometers. So that is the upstream distance. Downstream, it covers 24 kilometers extra, which is 216 kilometers. So that will be the answer, 216. Right, hope it's clear. If you just understand the sum and try to solve, becomes easier to solve. A faulty clock gains 6 minutes every hour. So first, let's calculate for 24 hours. If he starts at 12, we are saying how many times will it travel in the next 24 hours. So we don't have to calculate at 12 o'clock. We have to calculate further than that, next 24 hours. So 12 to 1, the hands of the clock doesn't meet. If you imagine it, from 12 to 1, apart from 12 o'clock, after 12, they don't meet. But after that, every hour, the hands of the clock meet. So after every hour, the hands of the clock meet. That means from 12 o'clock to 12 o'clock, they meet 11 times. Again, for next 12 o'clock to 12 o'clock, they will meet 11 times. So basically, in 24 hours, they meet 22 times. I'm ignoring the first time when they meet, 12 o'clock, because they're saying next 24 hours. Now, we are gaining 6 minutes every hour. So in 24 hours, you'll gain how much? So 24 into 6, 144 minutes you will gain. 144 minutes is 2 hours and 24 minutes. So we know from 12 to 1, he will not meet. In 1 hour, he will not meet. But 1 to 2, he will meet once. And from 2 to 224, again, he will meet once. So he'll meet 2 times extra. Remember, R and is between 10 and 15, between 2 and 3. So in 2 hours and 2 hours, 24 minutes, they will meet once. So total number of times they meet is 22 plus 2, which will give you 24 times they meet in the given circumstances. C option. Again, just need to imagine a little bit. Try to understand the clocks, how they meet, and this will become okay to solve. So there's a different kind of sums. You need to keep on practicing to just get a hang of different kind of sums. Right? Thank you.